The Data Transfer Tool, or DTT, is a command line-based utility that allows users to upload or download large molecular data files to the GDC. The tool can be downloaded from the GDC website under either Access Data or Submit Data, and is supported on Mac, Windows, and Linux systems. Here you can also find additional information, such as the DTT User's Guide, which contains extensive information, including helpful examples. Once installed, help menus are available for both the upload and download functions within the tool. For example, if I wanted to see the help menu for the upload function, I would type GDC Client Upload with the -H option. While the GDC Submission Portal can be used to upload all metadata entries, such as clinical and biospecimen information, the Data Transfer Tool, or the API, are necessary for transferring large files like FASTQ or BAM files to the GDC. This tool can work with both TCP and UDP transport protocols and can resume interrupted file transfers. Advanced options, such as specifying the chunk size or number of threads, are also available. Let's take a look at how to use the DTT for data submission. Later, I will demonstrate its use for downloading. Use of the DTT for data upload requires that you have already set up a project and uploaded all necessary biospecimen and experimental metadata. You can see more about those topics in the submission overview and submission portal videos. The data dictionary and data model pages are also excellent resources for understanding how to provide this information to the GDC. In this example, I have already registered my files, which includes providing the checksum and file name. This may have been done through either the submission portal or API. I can now use the DTT in a couple of different ways. Either I can specify the UUID, which is a unique ID for each entity within the GDC. Alternatively, I could create a manifest, which specifies multiple files simultaneously, and passes that information to the DTT. Submitting data to a project in the GDC requires authentication, which is tied to a user's dbGaP credentials. Such authentication is provided to the DTT through use of a token, which can be downloaded here. Additional information on data access can be found on the main website under Obtaining Access to Control Data or Obtaining Access to Submit Data. In this example, I am providing the manifest with the -M option and the token with -T. The process for using the tool for downloading files is very similar. Let me show you how to download a controlled access file from the GDC download portal. You may want to locate these files via the download portal interface, although the API can be used for that as well. Perhaps I am interested in specific files within the TCGA-BRCA project that relate to copy number variation. Just as with the upload function, you can specify UUIDs directly or create a manifest. You can also download a token in a similar way to the submission portal. But for open access data, a token is not required. In this command, I am downloading a single file. In this command, I am downloading a set of files specified in the manifest I recently downloaded. Please see the videos on the API and submission and download portals for more information on the topics introduced here.